Here I am with another video. In this video I will talk about a new theorem which is known as Reciprocity Theorem. For the detailed understanding of the theorem, I will suggest you to visit this website electricalengineeringportal.com and after this extension. Now let me clarify what is this Reciprocity Theorem. In many of the modern book you may not see this theorem, but in some older book this is a common theorem. Now what is this Reciprocity Theorem? The Reciprocity Theorem states that if an EMF in one branch produces a current I in the second branch. For an example, let's say I have a voltage source or EMF of 10 volt acting in this branch and it produces a current I in this branch. Okay, if the same EMF is moved from the first to second branch, it will produce the same current in the first branch when the EMF E in the first branch is replaced by a short circuit. Let me clarify the second portion of this theorem. This states that for the in first case, if we have a EMF acting at this branch and produces a current here, in the second case it states that if I move this voltage source to this position and measure the current through this path, that means our circuit will look like this. If I move the voltage source from this position and I connect the previous position of voltage source with a short path, then and I measure the current through this path, this current will be same as the current in this case. This is what our reciprocity theorem states. Now let me prove this theorem using a common example. Let's say I have a three resistance here, 5 ohm 7 ohm 6 ohm, and the resistances are supplied by a voltage source of 10 volt. I will calculate the current through this path, that means the branch in which this 7 ohm resistance is connected. So to calculate the current through this path, at first I have to calculate the total current. So how do we calculate total current? We divide total voltage with respect to total resistance. So what is the total resistance of the circuit? I have to calculate the total resistance with respect to the terminal where the voltage source is connected. The voltage source is connected across this terminal and this terminal. With respect to these two terminals, you will see that this 7 ohm and this 6 ohm resistances are connected in parallel, and their equivalent parallel resistance will be in series with 5 ohms, which I can write R equal to 5 in series will be parallel of 6 plus 6 and 7. Parallel equivalent of 6 and 7 will be equal to 3.23 ohm, so which finally gives us RT equal to 8.23 ohm. Okay, after calculating RT, I will calculate IT, that is the current that is outgoing from this source. IT equal to total voltage. Here total voltage is 10 volt and total resistance is equal to 8.23 ohm, so I will get a total current of 1.22 ampere. Sorry, this is a ampere, not ohm. After that, after calculating total current of 1.22 ohm, I will calculate the current through this path. That means I have to apply current divider rule. If I apply current divider rule, if I measure the calculate the current through this branch, I will take the resistance of opposite branch. That means I will divide the 6 with the sum of 6 plus 7 and multiply this whole fraction with the value of total current. 6 divided by 7 plus 6 into 1.22, which will be equal to 0.56. Now see, when the voltage source is connected at this branch, the current I is flowing through this is equal to this path is equal to 0.56 ampere. In the second case, I will move the current voltage source from here to here and replace the voltage source with a short circuit and measure the current through this path. Okay, see, in this circuit we displace the current source from here to here and we are measuring the current in this branch. Now see, I have placed the negative sign of the voltage source in the upward direction and the positive sign in the downward direction, because in our previous circuit current was flowing in this direction, so we have to preserve the direction of current flow in this circuit also. Okay, I have to calculate the current through this path. If I want to calculate the current through this path, I have to know the current that is emitted from the source. So to calculate the current source current, I have to know the value of voltage, total voltage with and the total resistance. So total voltage is equal to 10 volt, and with respect to these two terminal, I have to calculate our total resistance. See, this 6 ohm resistance and this 5 ohm resistances will be in parallel and their equivalent parallel resistance will be in series with this 7 ohm. So RT will be equal to 7 plus 5 parallel 6, which will be 7 plus 2.73 equal to 9.73 ohm. If I divide the total voltage with total resistance, I will get 1.03 ampere. Okay, so this is the total current. 1.03 ampere is the current that is emitting or outgoing from this source. After that, I will calculate the current through this path, that means the branch in which this 5 ohm resistance is connected. So if I want to calculate the current through this path, I will take the resistance of opposite branch, that means 6 ohm, and divide that resistance with the sum of this 5 and this, sorry, this 6 and this 5, and multiply that fraction with the value of total current. This is our special current divider rule. Okay, so I will get the current that is flowing through this path equal to 0.56 ampere. This is what our reciprocity theorem implies, that if I displace the current from here to here and measure the current through this path, I will get the same current as we get in our earlier case. See, in our earlier case, I get the current of 0.56, and here we get the value current 0.56 when the voltage source displaced from here to here. This is our reciprocity theorem. And one more thing that always remember, the reciprocity theorem is applicable when the circuit contains a single voltage source. Okay, that's it. Thank you.